Before, if you were to ask me what a Genesis G80 looked like, I wouldn't have been able to tell you, and I do this for a living. The first generation was handsome enough, but anonymously so. Almost as though its designers went the inoffensive route as not to alienate anyone. But this second generation? Man seems like someone, see also, Luke Donkerwoke, ex-Bentley and Lamborghini design chief, pulled out all the stops when designing the 2021 Genesis G80. The new G80 luxury midsize sedan now wears the same Genesis corporate fascia as the GV80 SUV. For a car that once erred on the polite side of bland, it's sure as hell a lot more memorable and striking now. And the great news is it's absolutely a joy to live with. 2021 Genesis G80 AWD 3.5T Prestige, by the numbers. Base price, as tested $48,745, $69,195. Powertrain, 3.5-liter twin-turbocharged V6 8-speed automatic transmission all-wheel drive. Horsepower, 375 at 5,800 RPM. Torque, 391 lb-ft at 1,300 to 4,500 RPM. Curb weight, 4,343 pounds. Seating capacity, 5. Cargo volume, 13.1 cubic feet. EPA fuel economy, 18 miles per gallon City 26 Highway 21 combined. Quick take, a midsize luxury sedan whose quality will blow you away. The second generation. The second gen G80, which slots above the G70 and below the G90 in Genesis sedan lineup, now rides on a Genesis-exclusive rear-wheel drive platform the automaker says lowers the overall center of gravity for better handling and increased interior space. Two engine choices are offered here in the United States, a 2.5-liter, turbocharged four-cylinder, good for a claimed 300 horsepower as standard, and an optional 3.5-liter, twin-turbocharged V6, good for a claimed 375 horsepower. You can get them both with either rear-wheel drive or all-wheel drive. All G80s come with an 8-speed automatic transmission. Fans of the previous G80, they exist, might notice the 5.0-liter V8 is no longer on the menu, which is sad but to be expected. The new G80 has a big, triangular grille and cool, dual slashes for its headlights, taillights, and side marker lights. Its winged emblem looks as though it slid down the length of the hood and a sweet line runs from the inner corner of its headlight, along the entire side of the car, to end at the slightly raised lip of the fastback design. Finally, we have a signature Genesis look, though it's not yet clear how it will age. But for now, I think it works great. Once upon a time, you could call out the G80 for ripping off a Mercedes interior, dash clock et al. You cannot level that criticism at it any longer. Now, the interior is its own, with a horizontal approach to emphasize width and clean, well-integrated lines. All G80 models benefit from a 14.5-inch central infotainment touchscreen display, though the driver information cluster on the four-cylinder models remains an 8-inch color LCD display throughout trims. The 12.3-inch 3D digital cluster only becomes an option once you select the V6 model. The windshield and windows are all made from acoustic glass. It, along with better door sealing, quieter wheels, and new sound insulation in the engine compartment, work to create a much quieter ride. The ride, regardless of highway or local driving, is incredibly smooth. It's also quiet at whatever speed you're traveling at, you and your occupants will never need to raise your voices to be heard. You can barely feel the transmission shifting and the brakes grab progressively and predictably. I could have done with slightly more communicative steering, but again, I understand the G80 is a luxury car. The priority here is comfort, not sniffing out every last ounce of road articulation. I could barely hear the 375 HP twin-turbo V6 the test car came with unless I really leaned into the throttle. Outside of just keeping the vehicle moving, its presence was invisible. This I also did not mind. The engine itself didn't have much character, but it was powerful and perfectly adequate at merges and passes. I suppose you could take the G80 on some backroads and it would certainly be fine doing so. But the overall sense I got from this car is it's a highly capable cruiser. I was able to get my seat nice and high up so I could easily see over the hood. Rear visibility was good, too. Behind the wheel of the Genesis, there's little urge to rush anywhere in particular because it's just such a nice spot to sit.